welcome to New Day Cleveland. I'm David Moss.
And I'm Natalie Herbick, and we are in Providence.
Rhode Island. Okay, Rhode Island. It's the smallest state in the union, but they tell me they've got big things to do, and so this is going to be a big show for you.
I definitely agree with that. You know, there's a lot of cars and buses driving around. One of the coolest ways to see the city is on the river, so we're going to be taking you out on a lovely gondola ride.
A gondola ride. Is that, don't they have some kind of thing here that has something to do with fire water?
Yes. It's water fire.
Water fire.
So
there
what
you go.
They
so
do.
So fire water is like this, but water fire is when you go out
you
here.
You go out there, they light the river on fire. So it's going to be a beautiful thing that we're going to get to show everyone as well.
You know, we love these food cities too. We talk about, you know, Portland, Oregon, a food town. Well, I'll tell you what, this little town, Providence, Rhode Island, is a great foodie stop. Johnson & Wales University, people go there to learn how to cook and how to entertain people. That's right here. So all those students come around here and they make it a great place to sit down and have something to eat.
Yes, they do. Rhode Island School of Design is here. Brown University is here. We're going to show you those schools in a way you might have never seen them before, too.
I'm headed to an Italian neighborhood where I know I'll find some good food.
Well, I want to go check that out. And I want to go check out the finest urban park in the country.
I'll see you guys.
All right. What a great way to start off this hour long. We are at Roger Williams Park. Bob, one thing after another, as I'm looking around, it just takes your breath away.
Oh, it's a great park, and it's been here for over 100 years, and generations of Rhode Islanders have enjoyed it. It was actually, the land for the park was given to the city by the great-great-granddaughter of Roger Williams, who was the founder of our state. And so ever since the 1890s, the park has been pretty much the same size, the same landscape, and it's a gorgeous landscape. One of the unique things about the park is that there are 100 acres of water. So wherever you go, the water is always in sight, and we try and take advantage of that for our visitors. We have duck boats, paddle boats. You can rent a canoe or a kayak here as well.
It's absolutely gorgeous. So how many acres?
435 acres. Yep. Jeez. And so if you come in here, there's all sorts of things to do. Besides the things on the water, you can go to the zoo. We have one of the best zoos in the country. There's elephants, giraffes, and all sorts of other animals as well. You can go on a ride a camel when you go there if you want.
You can ride on a camel?
There you go. Yep.
Wow, you don't find that in most zoos.
And if you come to the park in October, we have one of the most unique events in the country. It's called Jack-O-Lantern Spectacular, where we carve 5,000 pumpkins and put them out in a wooded trail all lit up. And it's just amazing. It's just one of the best events in the country. It's fantastic.
So what else? I know there are over 400 acres. I know there's so much more on this land to explore.
Yeah, so if you have little kids, there's a carousel. And we also have a Museum of Natural History, which has over 250,000 items. And we have exhibits constantly changing there. So whenever you come, there'll be something new to see as well. And most recently, we built a new botanical center in the park in 2007. And so that's a very, very nice place to see, particularly in the colder months. You can go in there in this tropical environment. It's really fantastic.
And then I'm sure in the wintertime, it's just as beautiful out here.
It is, yeah. There's plenty of sledding and cross-country skiing, so that's what people love to do. Yeah.
So no matter what time, I think, of year, someone wants to come and visit Providence and come to Roger Williams Park, they're going to find themselves.
That's true.
One great day, if not more.
And the zoo is open 362 days of the year, and the botanical center the same as well, and the Museum of Natural History. So you can come any time of year and have a great day.
So much to do, so much to see, and I think this is one great day to spend with a couple's family, just about anybody.
Exactly.
Well, David is up to something somewhere. I know what it is. He is taking you on a food tour of Federal Hill.
Oh yeah, we're gonna have some fun now. We're in Federal Hill, and don't tell Natalie, but I'm with Cindy Salvato here. That's a pretty name.
Thank you very much.
It's nice
to
be here.
Sicilian name.
A Sicilian name,
yeah.
Okay, that's perfect, because you know, in Cleveland we have Little Italy, but in Providence they have a place called?
Federal Hill.
Federal Hill, so check it out, folks. I had dinner last night right over here at Constantino's. It was fantastic.
Oh,
there was
great
music going on, all
great
kinds of great stuff. There's a bakery over here. It was closed the other night, so
yeah,
we're gonna go
Shallow
check.
Brothers Bakery.
We're gonna check that out, right?
Yeah.
And we're gonna go down here and check out a grocery store, but I wanna ask you about this sign I'm seeing right here. It says rabbits, ducks, eggs, quail, pigeons, geese. What kind of store is that?
That's a live poultry shop.
Live?
Live.
So they're clucking when you're looking at them?
They're clucking when you're looking at them, and you get to pick them out too, which is fun.
Okay, so we're gonna do that also, but first where are we going?
We're gonna go to Roma.
So look like Roma tomatoes over there, huh?
Yes, I think they are the best tomatoes.
And the place is called Roma?
Roma.
Okay, let's tell everybody, How do you know so much about what you're doing here?
Well, I do a food tour of Federal Hill, and this is one of my favorite stops.
And it's one of your favorite guys?
This is one of my favorite guys.
How you doing?
This is Dominic.
Good. Hey, Dominic, can I shake your hand?
Sure can.
Excellent. Oh, big hand, strong hand, huh? So what do you got going on here?
I got a truffle cheese.
Truffle
really,
cheese?
Really, delicious cheese. Would you like to try it, David?
Yeah, I'll try a little shot of that.
It's really fabulous. Good. You can see this beautiful truffle in the middle. See, it's just layers of truffle with sheep's milk cheese.
Oh, boy.
It's so totally delicious.
That jumps at you, doesn't it?
Pungent. Really, really nice taste.
That is excellent. How much is that a pound?
I'd say $34.99 a pound. But well worth it.
Yeah, it's got the real stuff in it.
The real thing.
Yeah. Sometimes you buy truffle oil, that kind of thing, but this is the real deal.
It's a real deal.
Right. And I say don't cook with it. Just eat it because it's too good to...
Wish you could taste it. There you go. Hey, thanks, Dominic.
Thank you.
Thanks, Dominic.
So what's going on with all this stuff?
We've got all kinds of beautiful stuff. Portobello mushrooms. We've got rolled eggplant. We've got eggplant campanada, stuffed eggplants, broccoli, rabi, and sausage. All made by Ruthie, who's one of the best cooks on the Hill.
Hey, Dominic, whose mom is making this stuff in the back room?
Mom?
Yeah, it all looks like
someone's mom, not mine.
It looks like Mama made all this stuff.
Does that look great?
It looks beautiful. And then we got some more hot stuff over here.
This is the Tavola Calda, the hot table. People can come in for a hot meal, pretty typical for for Italy and certainly for the Italian neighborhoods.
Ooh, look at these. Calzone.
Aren't they beautiful?
Oh, they're beautiful. Calzone, the way you say it sounds as pretty as your name there, huh?
Thank you.
That's beautiful. And look, we got some nice bread and a wood oven back there, huh?
Beautiful, yeah, where they make Neapolitan style pizza.
So the place is called Roma, and when you take people on your Federal Hill tours, you stop in here often?
We stop in here every time, and we talk about olive oil and cannoli and Italian pasta.
So this is the spot?
Yeah, this is the spot.
Okay, and here's cannoli. I love cannolis.
Well, this is a fabulous cannoli.
This is a great cannoli. I'm gonna give this cannoli a little bite.
That's a good cannoli.
You know what you're doing.
I love that cannoli. Yeah, it's one of
We're
my
We're going
faves.
To a bakery too, aren't we?
We are.
Let's go check it out.
We're going to go to Shallow Brothers.
I'm taking my cannoli. Thanks, Dominic.
Thanks, Dominic. Thank
you, guys. Whoa, what's going on back there?
We're starting the ovens to get ready to bake for the day. This usually happens around 3 o'clock in the morning. And then we also put it on 1 hour in the afternoon to keep it always warm.
You know what's interesting? It says brothers on the thing out there, but the sisters run it.
That's right. Yep, that's right.
So does Cindy do a good job for you here?
Excellent, yes. Mm-hmm. Of the whole area, actually.
Okay, so check this out here. Tell me what you got over here.
So we have a mail order business, which we started around 10 years ago. And a few of the things on the table are things that we have on our mail order. So we have the butter rum cake and the walnut streusel cake. Things like pepper biscuits, wine biscuits, garlic sticks, almond joys, all that kind of thing. We don't ship the bread because the bread has no preservatives or nothing to keep it.
Okay? Isn't it gorgeous?
Yeah.
Good, nice buns.
And then the cookie tray, which is a big seller on the mail order, too. That's like around 15 different Italian cookies on it.
I love the way this one looks right here.
That is very good. That is very good. That's called the butter rum cake.
So Cindy, I think you brought us to the right place, huh?
We did.
So how do you pronounce the name of the place again?
Shallow Brothers Bakery.
Shallow Brothers Bakery. How do you spell it?
S-C-I-A-L-O.
How did she do?
She did very well.
She did pretty well. You know, it looks like a little shop out front. You come back here, it's like the...
Totally amazing.
Yeah.
Shallow, like shallow water. That helps you remember how to pronounce it.
It's like Willy Wonka's factory back here. It's unbelievable, all the machines and everything.
Yeah, and then we make our own Schwiedel from scratch.
Wait, say that again.
Schwiedel.
Is that my quote?
Well, you should try it.
We all say it different.
Okay.
See, when you open it
then
up,
we have our cannoli shells.
It's all these beautiful layers.
Well, guess what? We've got so much to do at Federal Hill. We're going to see a whole lot more right after the break. Is that a good idea, Cindy?
That's a very good idea.
You should make this your specialty.
That's it. Well, we do. It is.
Oh, okay. After the break, we're back. Okay, here we go again, Providence, Rhode Island. Welcome back to New Day Cleveland and Cindy Salvato, right?
Right.
Not the new co-host, she's the lady, and what's your tour's called?
Savoring Federal Hill.
And this is Federal Hill, and we were just at Roma right down the street there, and the bakery right over here, and you say this is the next place we should check out.
Yeah, this is a fabulous spot, Venda Ravioli.
I don't even know where to start. Okay, so you're the tour guide here. How do you start when you come into Venda?
Well, we usually start by kind of going around this beautiful case here, and over here against the wall, there's some gorgeous ravioli that they make by hand, which
they're
famous
by hand.
For.
And all these foods are pre-prepared foods.
These are all pre-prepared foods, so people don't even have to cook. It's wonderful. You come in, there's Chef Gio. He's terrific. He makes all these beautiful things.
I would never cook again.
No, exactly, and you don't have to cook again. Look at all this great stuff, arancini, stuffed mushrooms.
There's Chef Sal over there, huh?
That's Chef Sal.
Having a little coffee, warming up. Hey, give me a little wave there, Chef. How you doing today?
Very good, thank you.
All right, I see you got your crew over here today, too.
Oh, yeah, they come every day, regular customers.
Think of all the things you find here on the way to the raviolis. And the raviolis, you make them right here, right?
They make them here. They have pappardelles, chef shells, manicotti. They have all kinds of beautiful bronze cut pasta here.
Yeah, and you know what? I saw all the raviolis were pointing at before. I mean, they got lobster, they got Italian sausage, they
broccoli
got everything.
Chicken walnut, all kinds of beautiful flavors.
This guy's on a tour too. You see that?
Yeah.
He's checking out the place. So we got the beautiful cheese.
Beautiful cheese department here.
And what's the name of this place again?
This is Venda Ravioli.
Venda Ravioli. Look at these olives, huh?
No. Could I have a few of those Castelvetrano olives? Because I think that David would love these. I tell people if they're not olive lovers to definitely try these first, because these are delicious. They're from Sicily, from the town of Castelvetrano. They're meaty, they're not salty, they're really delicious.
They're nice too.
Aren't they nice?
I thought they'd be harder because they're green, but they're not.
No, isn't it a gorgeous color? It's the natural color.
It's great. Now, weren't you telling me about a place where they have chickens and ducks and all that kind of crazy
they
stuff?
They do. Antonelli's Poultry.
Right across the way,
right
you
across
go?
The way, yeah. Let's go.
Let's go.
Okay.
Oh, bring the olives.
Oh,
they're
bring
too
the
good.
Olives. Okay.
Hey, we're talking poultry. Look at this big chicken here. I don't know how you pluck a chicken like that. You?
I can. I have some ideas.
You do?
Yes, I do.
I know who really knows. Chris over here does. How you doing, Chris?
Hi, how are you?
So you've been doing this for your family 150 years?
We've been doing that for about 150 years, processing chickens in the same location.
So when you buy chickens here, they're clucking when you buy it.
Oh, yeah, they're fresh. You walk in the back, pick your chicken out, kill it, clean it, process. I shouldn't have said the word kill.
Well,
I should have said eviscerate. We eviscerate chickens all day long. This is actually a silky, and that's a Rhode Island red.
Now, who buys a silky? Like, this? Is this the one that's...
Yeah, totally. I only got one here. You want to pull
look,
it up?
There you go. Look.
Go under the wing. This is where you want to go.
What, under here?
Yeah. See
oh,
how
yeah,
black
look.
It is? Yeah. The chicken itself, the feathers are white, but the chicken itself is black. Very good. Called a sugai in Japanese. A lot of Japanese customers like that. And that's a Rhode Island red. That's a female, by the way. The male would be a big dude.
And he'd probably be harder to handle, huh?
Yeah, he doesn't want anybody handling him, actually.
So why are people like accustomed to buying like fresh chicken like this? What's the deal?
Years ago, and it's like going in your backyard and picking a tomato. You go in the backyard, you pick the tomato. Why is that one always fresher than the one you get at the market? Well, you just picked it right then. So the same thing applies to any kind of fruit or meat or fish. Or anything like that, you know. So we're all in agreement with that. Right. The fresher, the better.
So tell me, Cindy, how popular is this stop on the tour here at Federal Hill?
Well, this is a really popular stop. We start our tour here at Antonelli's
because
Poultry.
Of this guy.
Because of Chris, he's great. He's the show. He's great.
I know where you got that from.
And people,
I'm kind of shy. As
he's calmed down a little bit now that the camera's on because this guy is a firecracker.
I won't talk.
Yeah, you
I'm having trouble just talking.
You're a firecracker.
You getting
dude.
This? All right, good.
Okay, excellent. Having a great time here at Federal Hill. Make sure you call Cindy. What are the name of the tours again?
Savoring Federal Hill.
Okay, great. Now, if you don't want to go off on the hill, or after you've been on the hill, you might want to go down to the river. It's gondola time.
I think I have found one of the most romantic things to do here in Providence. We are at La Gondola Providence, and I have Marcello with me. This is my first time on a gondola.
Is it now?
Can you believe it?
Well, congratulations.
I always thought it was going to be in Italy, but I'm in Providence, and I'm liking it just the same.
Well, you know, we've never claimed to be better or worse than Venice, just different. You know, there are pluses and minuses for sure.
How long have you been doing this?
This is my 16th season being a gondolier. Actually, my 15th anniversary of my first trip is this Friday, 4th of July.
Wow.
Yep. The company started in 97, 17 years ago.
So just being able to go along, was that the lure of everything, was for to bring people out onto the river and see the beautiful sights of the city that way?
In terms of how I got the job, I actually just said the right word at the right time. I joined the crew team at school the year before and was looking for a summer job.
That would definitely help
when
you're doing something like this.
So it's always simply been the greatest summer job in the world, and I'm very happy to get to continue doing it.
So who do we have here helping us out to get us going today?
This is Luciano,
okay.
Another one of our gondoliers.
So he's going to be taking us on a stroll?
Yep.
So who, I mean, I'm guessing couples are your probably the people who come the most, or am I wrong in saying that?
I'd say it's split about 50-50 between couples and more than couples.
And yeah. More than, like
three,
family?
Three or more, yeah.
How many can you fit on
up one to six
these?
Total.
Okay. Yep.
And really the trip gets tailored to the people that we have on board. You know, obviously a couple visiting, like celebrating their 17th anniversary or something, who are from Warwick, are going to be interested in a very different trip than, you know, a family of five from Ohio who are, you know, looking to find out about the city and things like that.
Very true. Now, how long is the ride?
It's normally about 40 minutes long.
So what do they see when they're going longer? And is it just the Providence River that we'll go on?
We actually started on the Wenasquatucket River.
This is the Wenasquatucket River.
Yep.
Okay.
It's Narragansett Indian for the river where the tide ends. And then in between these next two bridges, we move on to what the Narragansett's called the Great River, or the Big River, which came to be called the Providence.
Now, do you just take them on a ride? You don't start giving them a tour of what they're seeing around the city,
do
you?
It all depends on the people that we have on board. You know?
So can you do something like
that?
If they want to know what the sights are around them?
Sure, absolutely. I mean, there are some trips where I've done nothing more than sing a couple of songs, and there are trips where I haven't stopped talking the entire time. You know, it really comes down to, you know, whatever it is that you'd like.
So does he sing as well?
He does indeed.
Can we hear a little tune from you? Go ahead. So romantic. What's the most romantic thing that's happened? People like propose?
We do a lot of proposals, actually. Yeah. Would that I had kept better track. I've probably seen between 300 and 400 myself in the time that I've been rowing, and that doesn't include all the ones that other people have seen. So, you know, it's a pretty popular. Good home court advantage, you know. Nobody's ever said no. Yet.
That was wonderful. I don't want to make you keep singing if you don't. He's like, oh, okay. You're doing
it's
very
little,
well.
A little early to be singing.
He's doing very well. So they can catch you right along the Providence. What is this called?
The Providence Riverwalk.
Riverwalk.
Which was refurbished. This whole area actually used to be covered by one huge bridge. It was actually in the Guinness Book of Records, being the widest bridge in the entire world. And it's been refinished into this incredible park throughout the river.
And I know you can ride on one of these during, what is it called when the water is on fire?
Water fire.
Water fire?
It's
so
an
can
art
you,
installation
you can
here.
Get on one of these while they get to see that?
Yes, indeed. Yep.
Okay.
We operate 7 days and evenings a week, including on water fire nights.
Well, wait until you see this. If you think this takes your breath away, wait until you see what is coming up after the break.
Welcome back to New Day Cleveland, our very special road trip to Providence, Rhode Island. And this is, I think, maybe the star of the show. I'm here with Barnaby Evans, and we're walking along. What's the name of this river?
This is the Wenasquatucket River.
That's like saying the whole alphabet, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, just about. It's a Native American name.
Okay.
And Mushasic was just behind us. We just passed that, and this is the Wenasquatucket.
Okay, so I'm looking out here at the river, and people say this is why many, many people come to Providence because of these, what's this, baskets and these barrels
are,
out here?
These are braziers, and in them we light 100 bonfires later tonight.
So is this something that they've done in Europe before?
No.
Or this is something that you brought this,
is
you brought
a piece
this here?
That I created here to see if we could capture people's imagination and excitement about a place and figure out, we're all interested in fires and things like that. And it's about coming everyone together with music and entertainment and engagement. Lots of surprises. You're going to love it.
So I can see the riverbank filled with people. And
yep.
Then boats are going to come down the river. Is that how they get this thing started?
There are going to be about 20 boats that come down. They're the gondolas, which I think you've seen.
Oh, yeah.
And then there are performers on boats. There's Native Americans doing smudging ceremonies on the river. Performers.
What's a smudging ceremony?
Dances. Smudging ceremony is a Native American purification ritual to try to take the sort of hurt out of the world.
So this is all, this is performance art, really, isn't
exactly.
it?
It's a performance art piece.
Okay, so when we look out here at the river, how far back does this thing start? Where do you start?
So this goes for about half a mile, so you can see it going around the curve there. It goes all the way down to that checkerboard building, and then as it comes all the way around here, it goes all the way around the corner here and through those buildings and up to the brick mall there.
How would you describe the feeling people get when they see this for the first time?
Well, it's a sense, first of sort of stunning surprise. It's beautiful. It's about contentment. It's about peace. It's about quietly coming together. It's sort of like gathering together with your family at a small campfire and listening to music, except that you're in the embrace of thousands of people over mm-hmm. here in Providence celebrating this. So.
And does the shape of the celebration or the event change from occasion to occasion?
Yes. If you look at the website, you'll see all our dates, waterfire.org. And each one usually often has a theme or some sort of engaging surprise. We'll do something, we'll have salsa festivals, we'll have tango festivals, we'll have issues that of the day, so it changes all the time.
How often do you get a chance to do this?
We try to do it every 2 weeks from about April through November. Depends on funding, depends on tides, depends on the weather. Mm-hmm. But basically it's a chance to invite everyone from all over the world to come to Providence and celebrate what's special about being alive.
You know, you think about that magic of sitting around a campfire at night. It could be one little campfire and four or five people just sitting around it,
right.
And how entertaining that can be.
Exactly.
But you combine fire on water
exactly.
and all this activity, it's got to be magic.
And the water reflects the fire, and you see the fires burning up towards the dark sky, but then you see the reflection burning down. It's very strange.
Everyone I've talked to about this, when I brought this up, everyone, their eyes light up and they get excited about it. And to me, it almost has become part of the identity of the city.
Yeah, it has. This is 20 years we've been doing this. And when we first uncovered this river and created this park, the question was, how do you get people excited about a river? And that's what I came up with as an artist, is let's make it special.
Why hasn't somebody put you in a headlock, kidnapped you, and taken you to another city to
reinvent?
Oh,
we've done it in other places. We did it in Rome. Mm-hmm. We did it in Singapore. We've done it in about 20 places. And we're interested in those possibilities. We're talking to some other places. So it's a fun engagement.
I gotta tell you what, you're an artiste, man.
Yeah, I'm an artist.
It's great. Okay. Thank you very much. Hey, we were talking about Rome, right?
Yeah.
We're gonna go to a restaurant. It's not in Providence, Rhode Island, but it feels like it's really somewhere else. It's called Chez Pascal. You ever been there?
I have indeed.
Okay, we're going
excellent.
There. We're going there right after the break. Welcome back to New Day Cleveland. Yes, we are in Providence, Rhode Island, and I'm in a place called Chez Pascal, and everyone in town talks about this place. They give it rave reviews.
We'd like to hear that.
Yep, and this is Matt. Chez Pascal sounds sort of French, but I come in here, and I hear he has the worst kitchen.
We do.
What is the worst kitchen? How can it be the worst kitchen if it's a French restaurant?
Well, it's complicated, but we like sausages, we like hot dogs, we make all our own product. And we needed a space to sell it out of the window right to the street.
Okay, so we're talking about worse, like in
sausages.
W-U-R-S-T.
Yes.
It's not W-O-R-S-T.
No.
So look up here, we got some crazy ones too. So this is the worst lunch. You have chorizo with egg salad, pepper relish, hot sauce. What's that second
Thuringer. Kind? Thuringer bratwurst.
What's a Thuringer bratwurst?
Thuringer bratwurst is an unsmoked pork sausage. The chorizo is well seasoned. Some of the people from New Bedford would call it slightly different. All right, the Portuguese roots, but we say chorizo. The pork and fennel is a classic with beer onions, feta, and house mustard. Then we have a pork kielbasa with bacon onions and bacon jam. Everything there for lunch is served in a nice toasted roll. Again, depending on what sausages we're doing, they're either smoked or unsmoked.
Okay.
And then we have two sandwiches that we do, too.
Okay, so what's Lance doing back here?
Lance, we don't know what Lance is
doing, actually. Hey, Lance, is that the worst sandwich?
Well, that's one of the worst sandwiches.
That's one of the worst sandwiches.
So we do, again, we make all our own frankfurters. We make them here. We smoke them.
They're homemade franks.
All the sausages, the same thing. So he's putting together the kielbasa, bacon onions. So it's onions stewed down with our homemade bacon, just lightly caramelized. And then we finish that with bacon jam. So more bacon, brown sugar, red wine vinegar.
Now I know why everyone gets excited about this.
So this is all pork here, so it's a little hard for people who don't like pork.
Look how good that looks. Hey, so how crazy is this? So you pull up on the place, you got this window in the front like it's like an ice cream stand or a custard stand. It almost looks like a food truck that's stuck on the ground.
We had a food truck.
Ah.
So we had a food truck for 6 years, and we actually moved it along because now we have the worst. So, you know, here we can do, you know, beer and wine, we have restrooms, we have air conditioning.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's nice.
Okay, I get here, it's dark out already now, and I can still get, I still suffer from the worst. But then you're starting to make French food
then
on
we
the
have,
other side.
Right, we have a French restaurant. It's basically ingredient driven, very local. I mean, Rhode Island is great with having the proximity of all the farmers that we have here.
Yeah.
So it makes it really easy for us to get the local produce now, especially now we're getting into the height of the season.
It really intrigues me that you're talking about like worst stuff is sort of like German kind of stuff.
That's right.
And then you have French on the other side. So that's a little contrasty.
But all types of cuisine make sausages. It's just the names that separate them. So, you know, some people think, well, you know, the French don't make sausages.
Yeah.
They do.
I've only been here for a few minutes, but man, you're a great guy. I'd love
Thank
to
you.
Come back here. I hope everyone has a chance to come out here and check it out. Chez Pascal, easy to find.
That's right.
And if you just remember, the worst place.
The worst kitchen.
It's the best place. It's the worst
place. You can
find it. It's Chez Pascal.
We have fun with it. Thank
and you're
you.
Matt.
Matt, yep.
Okay, and Natalie, she's down the city.
Well, when you're touring and walking around Providence, there are a lot of great places to stop. This would definitely be one of them. This is the Down City Arts District. It's very eclectic here. There's a lot of interesting things. I see clothing stores, restaurant, a bookstore. But I want to stop here at this place because I want to find out a little bit more about this, including what it means. It's called Eno. You're the man with the answers, I'm guessing, Jerry. I want to know, what is Eno?
Eno is a name that we came up with based upon we lived in Italy for a year, and we lived on a vineyard, and we would go shopping at an Enoteca. So it's a wine store in Italy.
So that would make sense as to why we have a lot of wine standing behind us
exactly.
here today.
That and we like wine.
So you lived in Italy for how long?
A year.
You were there for a year.
Yep.
And is that why you kind of wanted to, what was your reasoning for bringing your experience there over to Providence here?
Well, I was in charge of the renovation of all these buildings. And when we completed this one, which was the last one, there were a lot of empty retail spaces. And it was by coincidence that a liquor license became available for auction. So I won the right to buy the liquor license and opened a wine store.
Absolutely wonderful. So I see a lot of different wines. How are they separated here? Is it
by country?
By country.
Yeah, and then it's by region, except in the United States where it's by grape.
So what would you suggest if I were to come in here and I want to, you know, enjoy myself a nice bottle of wine while I'm in the city? Like as far as a reasonably priced one compared to maybe a little
Well,
more
I'd start with, what is this just for drinking or are you going to have it with food?
Okay, say just for drinking. We'll go that way.
Okay, do you like red or white?
Red.
Okay, and do you like it heavy or do you like it light?
I like it heavy.
Okay, so you want something fruity. Do you like a lot of oak or do you want it
Oh man, there are a lot
See,
of questions
well,
to
no,
come along
but
with.
But I'm limiting
but
you.
Good.
You
know, that's
I got,
good because
I got 1,000 wine here.
You can help people out a lot, basically, by
exactly.
narrowing it down for them like
exactly.
that.
Exactly.
I'll take one of each.
Okay. You have a price range you want to be in, that becomes the next question, or not to exceed.
Now, you know, I would say, let's say $20
okay.
or under.
Okay, so I have a Super Tuscan that's $17.99. And it's outrageously good. And it's very atypical. I mean, for a Super Tuscan at $17.99, it's killer. So this will satisfy you in a lot of ways.
I love this because we have a $17 bottle of wine and then we have the $100 bottle of wine.
Yep.
Two over.
And then we also have one for $49.99 from the same producer. And it's a very unique wine because that's 100% Cab Franc, which you would normally never find in Italy.
So wine, obviously, is your big thing here. But as I look over on this wall, you have a lot of different spirits,
yes,
beers.
We do. Yep.
These are things, I'm noticing bottles that I haven't seen many places.
Well, we really like to do things that are interesting. So, that are interesting to us. And we taste everything that comes into the store. So, it's a tough job, but somebody has to do it, you know?
Exactly, right? Someone's got to do it. Like, do you have organic?
Yep, we have a lot of scotch. A lot of bourbon, we have a lot of small batch stuff. We go all the way across there in terms of our scotches. So we have the straight single malts all from Scotland, but we also have stuff from Ireland, from Japan. We have one that's a beer-based that's called Stick'em. That is very unique and kind of gets classified in there with the whiskeys.
And the beer, you have a whole section for just
we
dedicated
have,
to
we
beer
do
too.
Indeed.
So when people come in here, are they're wanting something to just sit around and relax with, or do you have a lot of visitors come in from out of town and want to take something home?
We have quite a bit, and the hotels send people over.
So no matter what your taste, whether you're wine, beer, spirits lover, I think
we
you got it here. You can take it on the gondola, you can take it home with you, and just enjoy yourself. Jerry,
absolutely.
Thank you so much.
My pleasure. Thanks for coming in.
All right, now coming up after the break, we're doing a little ghost tour. Have you heard of these around here?
No.
Of the colleges. You could come with us if you want.
I think I have to take care of the store.
All right. We'll go after the break. Welcome back to New Day Cleveland. Well, if you are interested in ghosts or the history of such an old town like Providence, this is the stop for you. We are going to take a Providence ghost tour, and Courtney here is going to be our tour guide. So Courtney, thank you first of all. I'm very excited to do this. This is our first stop. We're kind of doing a little condensed version. Where are we? And what has gone on here?
All right, so we are at one of the more active spots on the tour. We're at Woodsgary Mansion. And Woodsgary Mansion is the admissions building and a gallery space for Rhode Island School of Design, which is known as RISD around here. And this building just sings to us every night. It was the home of Marshall Woods. He was the original owner of this home, and this was his dream home. And so Marshall was a very type A personality, wonderful businessman. He lived here a happy, happy life. Then he passed away, and RISD eventually took over the building. And they report that his spirit rises, particularly when they're changing things around. They're adding in a new exhibit, they're moving offices, they're changing his ideal home and moving away from his ideal. This vision of a big, tall man with a very straight back and a bushy beard appears, and it begins to stalk through the house from room to room.
Okay, this is just the first stop we're going on to. Great, so much more to get to.
Mm-hmm. The tour walks you around the east side of Providence, which is the most historical. We go through a lot of the Brown University buildings and a lot of the RISD buildings. A few private residences, and then we bring you right back to the park where we begin the tour. So this is Brown University. We're sort of just coming onto the campus now. And the history at Brown University is some of the oldest in Providence. Brown University started in 1770. Mm-hmm. So the first building came up in 1770, and they just kind of blossomed from there on out. Shortly after 1770, though, the Revolutionary War began. And then that kind of changed the face of Brown and the history of Brown. So Brown University, the building here, actually emptied of the students, it emptied of the teachers, and it became a hospital for the French and the American soldiers. This is going to be our last stop tonight, and it's one of my favorite stops because it's a love story. So
I always
tell people to get warm and cozy with their loved ones. Anne Mary Brown was married to Rush Hawkins, which is a very fancy name.
I like it.
Uh-huh. And they were absolutely in love with one another, head over heels, and he was devastated when she passed away. So he had this building built for her, and the two are entombed in this building, but it also serves as a museum that chronicles their life. And there were very specific items that should have been kept in the building, and a lot of these items were removed over time. And so in the 1980s, this kind of came to a particular head, and Anne Mary's ghost was seen wringing her hands nervously. She would appear and disappear quite frequently, very unsettling to the staff that occupy the building. And so what they found was that she had love letters that were between her and Rush, and somebody had taken them, strewn them about the basement, and just left them. So when they found this, they covered them up. They put them in a box that says never to be opened. It's now safely behind glass, and after that time, her spirit cooled and calmed, and the building has an entirely new sense over it.
I love this. So we have just given you a small snippet of these wonderful tours that they can take. They can find you online, right?
Mm-hmm. ProvidenceGhostTour.com.
And you can get tickets, get them in advance. And mm-hmm. I think it is very interesting. You're gonna learn a lot, and you might, like me, get a little bit of chills too. Courtney, thank you so much.
Thank you,
Baxter, for taking us on the little tour. And hey, David's right around here somewhere. He's on the campus of RISD at their museum.
Well, once in a while we find a grand surprise, and we found one in Providence, and it's called RISD Museum. This is John W. Smith, the director. Nice to see you.
Yeah, hi, David.
Good, I got you. So RISD, that stands for?
That's the Rhode Island School of Design. And we're the museum of the Rhode Island School of Design.
And this is something that's sort of lived together for a long time.
It has. You know, the museum and the college were founded in 1876, really as a place for the training of artists and designers that could go into the textile factories and the jewelry businesses that were flourishing in Providence at that time. So really the idea, rather than going abroad to find designers, they would train them here at home. And they understood from the very beginning that part of that education should be a great museum. So the founders of RISD, the people of Providence, began building this, what is now an extraordinary collection.
One of the largest in the country, I understand. And I see some great things here. Like I see Karl Lagerfeld.
Karl Lagerfeld, yeah, yeah. I think, you know, one of the things that we tried to do in this gallery, this is our 20th century gallery, is to really kind of bring together all of the arts and really reflect the breadth of the museum's collection. Every direction that you look, there's something that kind of delights your eye. So it ranges from, you know, a great piece of contemporary sculpture by Richard Artschwager, this great piece, a wall sculpture by Linda Binglis.
That is incredible.
And then we have great earlier work by people like Jackson Pollock, Andy Warhol, Philip Guston. So we've really kind of honed in on all of the greats of the 20th century in this gallery. This is what we refer to as the Grand Gallery, and it really is the centerpiece of the main wing of the museum that was built in 1926.
Who's represented in here?
You've really got everything from Renaissance artists to French 19th century artists. It's really sort of just an example of trying to kind of replicate the grand galleries of the great European museums,
right,
and the great kind of royal collections, and an opportunity to really just sort of wow people when they walk into a room. You know, it's really about this kind of great visual impact in this.
I find it interesting that the museum was founded on the idea of textiles.
Right.
You know, and there are other parts of the museum you can examine textiles and see some great work. And then it grew into this then.
And again, I mean, I think it really reflects the founding, the founders of this museum, their own sort of the wide range of taste that they had, but also that their understanding that a great city like Providence was in the 19th century and continues to be, needed a great museum. And you mentioned textiles. We've got one of the largest textile collections of any museum in the world, about over 25,000 objects in our textiles collection alone. So we really like to, as much as possible, get our collection out on view.
You know, Northeast Ohio really supports museums, and I think, you know, to come here and see RISD Museum here in Providence, it's refreshing. I mean, I think it's really a fantastic
place.
Yeah,
it's a place that we're really proud of.
It's
terrific.
It's
a place that people here in Rhode Island have great affection and enthusiasm for.
You're a fun guy, too.
Yeah, thanks a lot,
Dave.
Hey,
thank you very much.
Yeah,
and guess what? Natalie's out there. She's doing a little discovery herself. Check it out.
After a busy day in the creative capital, take some time to recharge at Providence Marriott downtown. The hotel is conveniently located within walking distance of the city's bustling Riverwalk and Providence Place Mall. Or maybe you just want some time to refresh at Aqua, an urban oasis that blends water, fire, and sound into a relaxing pool and gathering destination. Refuel with a delicious meal at Bluefin Grill utilizing fresh, local ingredients. Providence Marriott downtown is sure to enhance your visit to the Ocean State. Welcome back to New Day Cleveland, and our road trip here to Providence is coming to a close. But you know, there's so many places we've seen. We've seen Federal Hill, we've seen Down City, we've toured
parts of the colleges, but Martha, I feel like there's so much more that the city has to offer that we even haven't scratched the surface.
Well, I think what you probably haven't touched yet is our historic district, which is called the East Side of Providence. And we have a street called Benefit Street, otherwise known as the Mile of History, surrounded by Rhode Island School of Design and Brown University, and loaded with beautiful restored homes, museums open for visiting, etc. So it's really a nice slice of New England history right here in Providence.
I feel like the city has, you get the best of both worlds because you have the small town vibe and yet the larger city vibe too, right?
Absolutely, and that's kind of how we like to position ourselves, is that we're kind of hip and sophisticated, but we still have that, not small town, but smaller town New England charm about us. So you really do get the best of both worlds. And I think that's evident in a lot of our attractions. It's evident in our culinary scene. We have fantastic restaurants. What you don't see a lot of chain restaurants here. You see a lot of chef-owned and operated restaurants with a variety of cuisines. You've seen that on Federal Hill.
Oh.
But we see that all over the city. Just some really fantastic restaurants. Many of them feature chefs from our own Johnson & Wales University and Culinary School located here in Providence.
And I think, you know, you've kind of started touching on this. I know that it's now called the creative capital here. And a lot of that due in part to the educational aspect, but the arts community too.
Oh, well, arts and culture is a part of our calling card without question. We have two of the finest performing arts venues in the country right here in Providence. We have Trinity Repertory Company and also the Providence Performing Arts Center. Both very, very different in their offerings, but both draw huge crowds and are very unique to Providence.
You have a great children's museum, I hear, here too.
We do, the Providence Children's Museum. Wonderful, wonderful hands-on exhibits for kids. Great afternoon activity for families, especially when you partner with the zoo. I mean, we have some really fun family time activities here in the city.
And as far as entertainment goes, is there anything we miss as far as places and attractions people can see? Because I feel like there's just so many things.
Well, in addition to all of our great entertainment, our art galleries, museums, etc., we have some great retail options as well.
Yes, I'm glad you mentioned that because that is the one thing I'm forgetting about, and it's standing right behind us.
Well, that's one of the options. We have this beautiful indoor mall called Providence Place, which is dining and shopping and entertainment options, but also we have some really wonderful, unique shops peppered throughout the downtown area, along the east side and also on the west side of Providence. So you can get the big city shopping here at Providence Place, but also some really unique and charming items throughout the city at smaller shops.
And is everybody here always this nice?
Oh, we like to think so. We like to say that, first of all, when you book a city, you get a state here in Providence. So you don't just get the capital city here, you get the entire state of Rhode Island when you come here. And the second thing we say is there's only one degree of separation. Everybody knows everybody. So if you need something in Providence or in Rhode Island, we can do that for you in just one phone call.
I love it. You've sold me, including a lot of great places to stay. You guys have a lot of great hotel accommodations throughout the city, so that makes it very easy for people coming into town.
Absolutely. Great hotels, and each of them is a little bit unique. We have some of the larger chain hotels, of course, but also we have some wonderful small boutique hotels, the New Dean Hotel, the Hotel Providence, the Historic Providence Biltmore. Lots of great offerings here in Providence.
I think we'll be back, Martha.
Fantastic. We're ready for you.
Well, we did make it to where Martha wanted us to come, the east end of town. We are finishing out here, and this is probably the closest you and I are ever going to get to an Ivy League college, huh?
Yeah, Brown University. Is that what it's called?
Brown.
Yeah, baby. That's the biggie. That's a dynamite school.
This trip has been so wonderful. I think we've seen so many amazing things. We've seen the city in a lot of different ways, too.
I love that water fire thing at night. Boy, that was just unbelievable. And so what do you like better, the gondolas or the gondoliers?
Oh, I like the gondola better, although they can really sing, I'll tell you.
That's pretty good.
It's neat to see something in a city like that. And you know what? It is a small town, so you can really manage your way around it, but they do have that big city feel.
Love the architecture. You can walk around, you see some great stuff. The old buildings downtown are beautiful. You get
gorgeous.
Out here in the edges of town, it's fantastic. And the food, Johnson & Wales, their school's here, so the food is great. Everywhere you go, it's a lot of fun.
I've had a great time here. I think you have too, right?
What's it called? Providence, Rhode Island?
Providence, Rhode Island. Make it a stop on your next road trip.
Like I said, it's a little estate in the union, but it's got a lot of big time fun stuff to do. I'm David Moss.
And I'm Natalie Herbig.
We'll see you on the next
New Day Cleveland.
So long.